In this video, I'll explain what a HubSpot module is and how they're used inside the HubSpot website builder. Hi, I'm Jake Lett. I share digital marketing tips and HubSpot tutorials to help you grow your business. Okay, let's get started. HubSpot modules are reusable components that can be used in page templates or manually added to pages. A good way to think of how a module works is by comparing it to a Lego set. When building a Lego set, you are given different types of blocks that you can configure it to whatever you like. In HubSpot, you can choose between different field types that can be configured into different things using HTML, CSS, JavaScript, and Hubble. Hubble is a server-side templating language that gives you the ability to write programming logic. HubSpot modules are generally designed to work one of two ways. The first way is a full width section module. Common examples of this are header and footer, hero carousels, and content tabs. It wouldn't look right to have two of these modules side by side. The second way is having them as a content module. These can work with other modules next to them or stacked above and below them. Some examples of these are rich text, image, icons, and a responsive video embed. These content modules are usually manually grouped together inside of a column grid. Now that we know what modules are, let's now see how they look inside the HubSpot page builder. When you open up a new page, you'll see it says drop modules here. And where you find your modules are on the left-hand side. You can search for modules in your higher account, and every theme has built-in modules within them. And in this case, I'm using the growth theme, which is the default HubSpot theme. And this contains a bunch of these modules already inside of it. So you have an accordion, a button, icon. I'll just show you the tabs. And you can see it has one tab and two tabs, or you can click on this add button, and this will allow you to add another tab. And if you click on this little down arrow, you can hide that. And then there's common modules. And the common modules are default for HubSpot that are applied to the whole entire account and not just inside of a theme. And if you have any other modules that are inside of your account, they would be inside of this all modules section here. At this point, if you have any questions about HubSpot modules, please leave them in the comments below. And if you'd like to learn more about the HubSpot CMS, I have a free beginner's guide you can download on my website. It goes into more depth about how to build page layouts, and it shares some important things you should know if you're more familiar with WordPress. You can find the link to this free guide in the video description below. So I kind of want to show you these two sections and where they are inside of your design tools area. So if you go into your design tools, which is under marketing design tools, you'll see these two folders here with a at symbol in the front, HubSpot and marketplace. Any themes that you purchase in the marketplace will be shown inside of here. But if you click on the HubSpot one, you'll see the growth. And this is the theme that I have that I'm using on this page. So if I open up that, you can see the modules folder, and you can see a bunch of modules that are displayed here. So that's kind of where those are coming from. The modules like over here where it says common modules like rich text, heading, you'll see those here if you don't go under growth folder. Let's see, rich text. There it is, rich text module. So you can kind of open up these if you're curious to see how these are built. Obviously you can't edit them, but you can definitely see how they're structured and built. If you'd like to learn more HubSpot CMS tips, click into this playlist right here. And if you haven't yet, subscribe for more digital marketing tips and tutorials. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.